There's something about the West that gets in your blood. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the people. Maybe it's the vast landscapes, or maybe it's the fishing. We're in Dubois, Wyoming, part of Wind River Country, and we're on the hunt for cutthroat trout. This big fish adventure starts right now on The New Fly Fisher.
Gotta be a fish right there.
Oh! See, I love the idea that these fish have got no idea that we're even here.
Yep, there we go.
It's a good fish too.
Nice.
Man, it's so cool in this clear water. You can see them come up, right? Need it? Got him? Sweet.
Oh, this one's fat. Good, good, good Yellowstone cutthroat.
Beautiful fish.
Literally a half mile or more of beautiful fast water. Perfect for Arctic grayling, but we're safe here. That didn't take long.
The New Fly Fisher is supported by Wind River Visitors Council, Orvis Fly Fishing, Trout Unlimited, Rio Products, Oscar Blues Brewery, Global Rescue, Adipose Boatworks.
Welcome to Dubois, Wyoming in Wind River Country. Dubois, nestled in the Wind River Valley, brings you back to the old days. Old days of the cowboy, with its culture, boardwalk sidewalks, and the unmistakable frontier days feel you get walking the main drag. The Wind River runs straight through the heart of town and adds a fly fishing flair to all that is cowboy here in Wind River Country. With seemingly countless opportunities for anglers to explore on foot, by drift boat, or a drive-to tributary, the fishing in Dubois and the surrounding area is tremendous. On this Wyoming adventure, we're staying with good friend Jeramie Prine. Jeremie runs Dunior Fishing Adventures and family-owned Ram's Horn Guest Ranch. The ranch is perfectly positioned in the heart of the Absaroka Mountains, with access to multiple rivers and high mountain streams for rainbow, brown trout, and the jewel of Wind River Country, the Yellowstone Cutthroat. Ram's Horn Guest Ranch is located centrally to access all that Wind River Country has to offer. Joining us on this small stream adventure is expert guide Noah Stutter and good friend Tom Rosenbauer.
Well, things are starting to heat up.
Tom and I are here to experience all that Dubois and the Wind River region has to offer. Most exciting for us are the small mountain streams and small rivers in the area, all chock full of wild trout. Small stream fishing speaks to the essence of the beginnings of fly fishing for many of us. Stealthily hunting fish on small meandering creeks, ever so mindful of each step and movement. It takes us back to our beginnings, and even more excitedly, the future beginnings of many new anglers getting into fly fishing. Our first day at Dunior Fishing Adventures finds us loading up and heading into the mountains, admittedly, onto one of the most beautiful trout streams we've ever seen. We approach a run and are immediately left in awe with what unfolds in front of us. I draw the short straw. Tom's up first.
So I'm chomping at the bit to go and catch these rising cutthroats behind me. But before I do, before I jump in the water and ruin everything, I want to talk to you a little bit about why those fish are there and how you can use that reading the water. So in a high mountain stream like this, the water's really clear. You don't see any algae on the rocks. The rocks are very clean. There's not a lot of food here. So those fish are gonna have to be in that main current thread to catch all the food that's drifting down. So when you're prospecting and you don't see anything rising like this, that's where you wanna look. So I've got a bunch of cutthroats rising up here in this pool, a whole pile of them. And I put on a big attractor dry, which usually works for cutthroats, but it didn't work. So I'm gonna have to match the hatch. And I seen some kind of olivey, fairly good sized mayflies here along the rocks. So I'm gonna put on a mayfly emerger and see what I can do with these fish. Whoa, that's a nice fish. I can't see him. I didn't know how close he was to the net. There he comes. Whoa. Wow. Woo.
Nice job, Tom.
Wow. That is a beautiful cutthroat. Ugh. Oh, big look. Oh, another look. See a good rise?
That's a good fish.
Yeah. Yeah, you just won't give up.
No.
I mean, 5X, I gotta be a little careful. Ah, don't you dare do that. So this beautiful fat cutthroat is a good example of changing your positions during a hatch. I have been fishing from this bank and getting a little bit of drag, I guess, because the fish on the far side of the seam just wouldn't take the fly. They'd refuse it. I could see them coming up and looking at it. They wouldn't take it. So I moved myself around to the tail of the pool so I could shoot straight upstream to the fish, and bingo, it worked.
After a few fish, it's my turn. Jeremy and I head upriver in search of some new water. We didn't have to walk far.
All right, so, big wide piece of river.
Yep.
You want me to attack it the same way we're gonna fish downstream?
Yep.
Well, upstream, flies coming downstream.
Yep.
And just every
Yeah, just treat
feet.
It like a grid and pick your way all the way across it and leave no water untouched.
Okay. Just blows my mind that it'll be that tight to the shore.
Yeah.
So skinny.
Yes. Nice catch, Mark.
Yeah, man, so we paired down from a size 12 Adams down to a 16. And, you know, it's a different kind of technique to cast upstream and bring it down to. You really have to watch your line management,
yes,
don't you?
Yes, you do.
It's good fish.
The nice thing is your fly line usually lands behind your fly, and that's a common mistake people make, is getting their fly line too close to a little fly like this. We'll just take our time, you know, 5X tip it, so.
It's a good fish to start the day, man.
Yeah, good job.
Now the water is freezing cold, so you do not need to worry too much about temperature fatigue with these fish.
You don't.
Big shake head. It shakes. Whoa. But you can see everything. Everything is so super clear in this water. You can see the take, you can see the refusals, you can see the fight. And you can see them trying to go between your feet. Nice.
Beautiful
Jeremy.
Job. Nice job.
Sweet. All right, let's take a look at this. Now, for the first fish of the day out of this fantastic high mountain creek, how do you like that? Not bad for a Yellowstone cutthroat. Good fish. Now, is that a big one, a small one, average? What's the deal?
That's a decent size. They do get bigger in here, and they get smaller in here as well. We've been seeing more of these big fish in the Dubois area, thanks to the management of the Wyoming Game and Fish. And you can't kill these fish. They're all catch and release.
All catch and release. Well, let's do just that. Thanks, buddy. There he goes.
Excellent
job. Not bad
job.
To start the day, huh?
Yeah, excellent job. Thanks, brother.
Nice hook set.
Perfect.
Oh, that's a beast. Nice fish.
Ooh, look at how large it is underneath. Ooh, Jeremie.
Nice job, Mark.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Now,
look at the colors on that.
Now, one of the things that Jeremie taught me about in setting the hook on these cutthroat trout is it's one thing to wait for the fish to turn and a gentle lift, but you also have slack in the water from a downstream drift. So as your fly is floating down the river, you really need to manage your slack such that when you do that gentle lift, sometimes you have to do a little bit of a strip set too, to manage that slack so that it comes tight gently, right?
That's correct.
Cool.
Yep. That was a perfect hook set, Mark.
Jeremie, how do you tell the difference between a Yellowstone trout and a Snake River trout?
So a Yellowstone cutthroat has more spots concentrated at the tail and not so many in the body, as you see there. That's a fine example. Where a Snake River, it's fine spots throughout it. So the spots are finer on a snake, and on a Yellowstone cut, the spots are bigger, more concentrated at the tail.
Cool. But they both have the telltale.
Yes.
Chin gash. Awesome stuff. So here's a fly we're using. Just a simple mayfly pattern. Doused in gunk, floating riding high. That's what did the trick.
Cutthroat trout, the state fish of Wyoming, is found throughout many of the state's clear, cold, and clean mountain streams and rivers. Due to the fact that cutthroat trout need pristine water conditions, they are considered an indicator species. The prolific presence of cutthroat trout proves suitable habitat for many of their 14 subspecies and tell anglers the rivers are perfect. Cutties generally eat very differently from other trout species. They tend to be slow sippers, rising gently to a dry fly, seeming to examine it before ever so subtly sipping it down. Getting your timing right to effectively set the hook on a cutthroat takes practice. If you've never done it before, give yourself a break and give it some time. It will come.
So I am being totally humiliated by these cutthroats. Cutthroat trout are supposed to be stupid, right? Well, these fish are not stupid, and I've put 4 different fly changes over the fish. I've tried my best presentations. It's just not working. So in a situation like that, during a hatch, one of the things you suspect is drag. So what I'm gonna do is put on a longer, lighter tippet. I had 4X on. I'm gonna go to 5X, and I'm gonna put a pretty long tippet on. Hopefully I can get a better drift, and I'll change flies too, just to make sure.
Ooh, oh! That one was 8 inches. They're getting bigger.
I love doing this.
The next day, we head into the hills in search of micro streams for high elevation, dry fly cutthroat. Jeremie sets us up on a tiny creek he knows in Wind River Country, and we aren't disappointed.
Jeremie, another fantastic day here in the high mountain peaks of Wind River Country. We're after cutthroat again, but on a super small stream with a new technique, glass rods. Big fun, huh?
Excellent fun. A lot of fun for beginners, families to come out and experience Wyoming, catch a lot of cutthroat trout. And this is a place to do it. You can't beat the views here.
Lots of fish in these creeks?
A lot of fish in these creeks, yeah.
Perfect for somebody that wants to get their the feel right for those difficult hook sets.
Yep.
For the big ones.
Exactly.
Cool, man. Let's see what we can do.
Most modern day fly rods are designed to cast effectively 30 or 35 feet and longer. On these small streams, you need to adjust your setup to be able to cast lines in small areas and shorter distances. Well, how do you do that? You can go with a shorter, slower rod, such as a fiberglass rod, or you can simply overline the rod you have if you don't want to buy a second or third rod. For example, if you're fishing a 4-weight rod, consider overlining it by one or two line weights and throw a 5 or a 6-weight. That will bend the rod more and allow you to cast short distances with accuracy.
Jeremie, in these small little creeks, I'm assuming that the fish will relate still to undercut banks and structure like that?
Absolutely. Cutthroats love cut banks. They love root structure. They like hiding in places that most other species of trout don't really hold in. Yeah. There it is. There
nice.
It is. Beautiful hook set. Beautiful. Way to come off of that shelf. You see how they can hang right up in the shallow, just waiting for food to come in.
And that fly did. It came right off the shelf and boom, he ate it.
You can see how the spots are concentrated more at the tail, like yeah. We were talking about yesterday.
Yeah, yeah.
Just those colors are magnificent. Even a small fish like that, just beautiful. Nice. Nice fish. That's a little bigger.
Great fish. You know, in these small streams, size of fish doesn't matter. Numbers are fantastic, but when you get a good one, it's a good one. 5X tippet. Very delicate presentations for big cutthroat.
Slippery too. There we go.
Nice.
It's a better fish. That is a beauty.
That's a. Can you imagine coming into Wyoming and catching stud cutthroat out of small streams like this? Super fun. Just nothing more I can say about it. Just amazing. Out of the mouth here. There we go. And then we can let them go. Thanks, pal. What a great fish. Small stream cutthroat in the winds of Wyoming. Fantastic. Good fish. Best fish of the day, man.
Yeah.
In a small stream, you can't beat it.
No, you can't. There's a bigger fish. You never know when you're going to find one in a small stream. Now, that's a trophy in a little stream like this. Doesn't happen all day long. But when it does, it sure is exciting.
What a great morning. As the sun got higher, we decided to head to another creek in the area in a bid for cutthroat, and maybe a brown or two.
And this is all catch and release here too?
Yes. Yeah, pretty much all of Dubois is no kill policy on cuts. There it is.
Ooh, that's a good fish.
That is a big one. Take your time.
All right, so we've moved into a public part of this river and we've had some fantastic success early. You know, 3 or 4 casts, and each one has produced a cutthroat trout. So, and this one so far is the big one. And after yesterday's debacle of of working to figure out how to hook these fish, we finally, I've got a pattern now.
You got it. Just slowing it down, right, Mark?
Yeah, it's all about slow.
That's a beaut. It's a pretty fish.
And this is public water too, which is amazing. This cold water, they are not the worst for wear, let me tell you. So we've come gunned with a 5-weight and a 6-weight fast action rod. Helps with the wind, and sometimes if we're throwing big hoppers, helps punch that wind too.
There it is.
Good take. Ooh, big fish. Ooh, big fish. Oh.
Nice job, Mark. Beautiful hook set. Ooh, that's a toad. Wyoming cutthroat. Man, that is a specimen. I'm gonna come down here on the other side.
Now, I'm really glad that we spent the morning up on that high mountain small creek practicing hook setting on little fish and having chances of with lots of them. It's a good opportunity to shake the lead out, get warmed up, come down and tangle with giants. Man, they go right to the wood, don't they?
Yes, sir.
We got time.
Oh my goodness. That was a pretty fish.
Nice. Best fish of the trip. Put her there, man.
Sweet.
Woo! So, big fish of the trip. Man, that's a stud cutthroat and strong. Is this indicative of what people can catch in public water here?
It really is amazing, the size and the amount of fish you can catch in public water. And a lot of that's due to our fish management and really taking care of the cutthroat in particular.
16-inch cutthroat?
Yeah.
Can't beat it, right?
Can't beat it.
All right, we're gonna let him go. Oh, feels good. Look at that. Just fantastic. Built in the 1920s as a railway tie cutting camp, Ramshorn Guest Ranch today is a wildly comfortable homestead for adventure seekers. Six of the main buildings still stand lovingly restored for the ultimate in privacy and seclusion for any angling group or family. The cabins are well appointed with running hot and cold water, 24-hour power, and Wi-Fi if needed. With access to seemingly countless rivers and creeks in the area, Ramshorn Guest Ranch has it all for those looking for a quieter step back in time and world-class angling. The next day, we load up the trucks and head back into the mountains in search of wild cutthroat. Wild cutthroat in wild places. Perfect. This is Noah Studdard. He's a guide with Dunior Fishing Adventures. We are on another tributary of the Wind River here in Wind River Country. Things are different from the last few days, aren't they? Things are moving in clouds and all that.
A few clouds. With the cloud cover, we'll probably switch up to a dry dropper, but right now, while the sun's out, we'll probably just stick with just a dry.
Right, so, we've been watching these pools and we haven't seen anything rising. That doesn't mean, though, that they won't eat a mayfly, right?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Not at all. They still could eat. They're used to eating it. They've been eating on mayflies for a couple weeks now, so okay. They should still be.
One final question.
Yeah.
What's with the gun?
A lot of bears.
Grizzly bears, right? Okay.
Funny.
I feel safer now, thanks. Whenever possible, I always try to fish with the sun on my back. It decreases the amount of glare in the pool and allows you to see into the water to see if there might be cutthroat or other fish swimming around. But having the sun at your back also creates another problem. It's later in the day. The shadows are getting longer. If I approach this pool too quickly, in this scenario, I might actually spook those fish with my shadow. Not only the shadow from my person, but the shadow from my fly rod. So when approaching a pool, please keep in mind your shadows and stay back a little bit and slowly move your way in.
Yep. There we go.
good fish. So Noah spotted this fish eating off the surface there. Oh man, quick and easy. Look at that. Don't you love it when that happens?
Great job. It's a good fish.
So it pays when you approach pools to stand back, stand well back. Don't let yourself be known. A well-placed cast, drag-free drift, and the result is Yellowstone gold. So this one actually was feeding on the surface. Noah spotted him as we approached. There he is, look at that. How do you like that? Just great, great cutthroat. no worse for wear,
yeah,
huh?
Wasn't he?
Sweet.
Good job. On to the next one.
You know, the last couple days, I've noticed that the cutthroat trout have not been cutthroaty at all. They've actually been super aggressive on their eats. Yeah. Today's a different story. They've gone back to what cutthroat trout, what I remember cutthroat trout, feeding like very sippy, very slow, checking things out. Why does that happen?
Well, there's a couple reasons. The main reason, I believe, is the cloud cover that we have today. It's not as sunny out. There's not quite as many bugs. Mm-hmm. So they're a little more hesitant when they come up and check that bug out. They're making sure it's what they think is a bug before they just eat it. And another reason is this time of the year, mm-hmm. As the water's coming down, you'll find more cutties in the main part of the run, in the middle of the run, in the channels.
As opposed to the edges?
Exactly, whereas opposed to the pockets.
Right.
Like the pocket water on the side of a fast eddy or in a back eddy.
Yeah.
Is where you'd usually find cutthroats earlier in the season, but this time of the year when the water is at the right level, it'll be a little more comfortable in the middle of the runs.
So they don't feel the need to smash. They can come up and just sip the way that cutthroat usually do. Cool. Well, I like it. I like it because it's super visual and tests your patience.
There's nothing quite like a dry fly eat, a slow dry fly eat.
Yeah. See, I love the idea that these fish have got no idea that we're even here. No clue.
Yep. There we go.
Good fish too.
Nice.
Sweet fish. Get him on the reel. Man, it's so cool in this clear water. You can see him come up, right? And eat it.
Beautiful fish, every one of them.
Oh, it's a good one. Whoop. With 5X tippet on, you really do have to manage your drag. You have enough drag that it'll slow them down, but you know, not enough that you risk snapping them off. Even 5X, I think, is a little stout. All right, let's see if we can get his head here. Got him? Sweet.
Very nice.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Yes, it is.
Gorgeous. These fish are still taking mayflies on top. We haven't had an opportunity to need to put a dropper on. I guess we should just continue until they stop, right?
Exactly.
So is that the indicator that you start putting droppers on, is they just stop eating off the top?
Yeah, and usually with this cloud cover coming in, we could very easily need a nymph here later, but as long as this is working, there's no need to fix something that's not broken.
Okay, oh, this one's fat. Good, good, good Yellowstone cutthroat.
Beautiful fish.
Stealth is the key. Now that guy was at the tail of the pool, which tells me that chances are the big one is up top. That was a good fish.
It was. Yep. There we go. It's weird. I think this one in the bottom was bigger.
Yeah. Now, this fish isn't as big as the last one, but it was hanging out in the dominant spot in the head of the pool. significantly smaller. Look at that gash, isn't that cool? It's fluorescent. So maybe he's just got a bad attitude, this guy.
There he is.
Nice. Oh, wow.
He's bigger than I thought.
Yeah, good fish.
He's a good one.
Oh, yeah, great fish. Now, we pinch the barbs down on these hooks. Woo! Hot. Look at that. Nice job. Woo, big one of the day, man. Look at that.
That's what we were looking for.
Got some battle wounds too, huh?
No. A lot of the bigger ones will have. That may be where. So some of them, when they get older,
yeah,
they'll have scars on their backs where osprey have tried to get them.
Yeah.
That, I would say that's from spawning, but it's a little very easily do from an osprey.
Well, take a look at this.
Osprey or eagle.
For the past week, we've been targeting brown trout, rainbow trout, and cutthroat trout here in Dubois, Wyoming, out of Wind River Country. And it's been a fantastic adventure, fishing small creeks and big rivers. The equipment that I used while fishing for these fish is as follows. 5-weight and 6-weight 9-foot fly rods, large arbor reels with floating matching lines in 5-weight and 6-weight. The tippet that we used was interesting in that we used 3X tapered leaders followed on the end with 4X tippet. Now, the flies are interesting as well. We stuck with basic hopper dropper patterns that included grasshoppers, chubby Chernobyls, and of course, droppers in nymphs and crayfish. Today, we're changing gears and staying put just outside of Dubois on the Wind River. Brown trout, rainbows, and cutties are the order of the day, a Wyoming Grand Slam on the Wind.
This is Rusty Comers, a guide here at Dunior Fishing Adventures. Rusty, we've been dancing with cutthroat on the tributaries all week. This is a little bit different. We're in the big water now. What's up?
We're gonna have some dry fly action here in the big water. Some parachute flies, big browns looking up, rainbows. There'll be a few cutthroats in here as well.
Okay. Okay, so this river cuts right through the heart of Dubois, and it's public water. We're gonna have a great day today, I guarantee that. There we go. Took the nymph on top. Woo, nice fish. So I switched over to a hopper dropper with a little pheasant tail as the dropper, and the mayflies that we were fishing with just weren't doing anything, so decided to switch on over. And right up against these rocks in the shadows, it looks like we got ourselves a brown trout. Ooh, I've got 5X tippet on here. Gotta be careful. Nice brownie.
Nice little brown at the pheasant tail.
Yep. Sweet. How do you like that? What a good looking fish. Those orange spots, good one. First Wyoming brown trout. Can't complain about that in any way. That's a sweet one. See you, buddy.
Nice.
Here we go.
Whoa, nice fish.
All right. Grab the net.
Good one. What fly did you put on there, Rusty?
Put a bigger prince nymph on there.
Whoa.
Nice brown. That is a good one. Oh, it's a rainbow.
Feisty, feisty.
With that hopper dropper rig, as soon as there's any movement on the grasshopper, lift and set.
Yeah, hook set.
That's what it was. It just barely went under the surface of the water. And best rainbow of the trip. Now we do pinch the barbs down on all of these. Nice. Now this is what you come to Wyoming for. Look at this. Boom.
That's a solid bow right
that
there.
That is fantastic. We thought we were getting away from the cutthroat, but not so. This looks like a rainbow, but it's actually a cut bow. And you can tell by the slash under its jaw and also by the leading white edge of the fins as well. So great fish, right?
Yeah.
It's good fish for this river, isn't it?
Very well.
Yeah. Okay, we're gonna let him go.
All right. Good catch, good release, Mark.
Look, going right to Tom. Awesome stuff.
Thank you. So why do you even need to learn how to read the water? Well, trout aren't everywhere. In a lot of rivers, trout are only gonna be found in maybe 10% of the stream bed, of the wetted area of the stream. So you gotta narrow things down or you drive yourself crazy trying to fish everywhere. So for instance, we've got a bend in the river here and the current's fairly fast. It's a good sized river, the current's fairly fast, and the outside of the bend looks kind of tasty, but it's actually that current is too fast. Trout aren't gonna lie over in there and feed. They're gonna stay on the inside of this seam. And the other thing you wanna look for is color change. The fish are gonna be usually on the color change. So where the bottom changes from this kind of yellowish, brownish sand into a darker green is where the fish are gonna be. So you just look in here and you can ignore lots of water over there and just fish on this inside part of the seam.
Ooh, nice fish. Whoa!
What? Why isn't he moving? Oh, there he comes.
Oh, it's a big brown trout, I think.
Wow, that inside seam, just this, and I only have 5X on here. Most people fish 4 in here, but I'm babying this fish a little bit more than I normally would. Use a little side pressure, see if I can move him. That is a big brown trout. I think it's a brown trout. Didn't get that good of a look at it.
Wow, man.
I can't move him. Acting like a brown trout. Maybe if I get him in this mud here, he'll get a little disoriented. I'm gonna bring him up into this shallow water. Oh my God, what a beautiful brown trout. What a gorgeous fish. The old inside of the seam. You would have thought that fish would have been over against that fast water, but he was right in here.
Oh. Hook's out.
Ooh.
And I'm gonna bring them over here into this clear, shallow water and release them. Bye, buddy. Thank you.
Well, that about does it for this episode of The New Fly Fisher. We hope you enjoyed this amazing adventure from Dubois, Wyoming and Wind River Country. I want to thank Jeramie Prine, Noah Studer, and Rusty Comers for their expert guidance. What a fishery. For more on this destination, check out more from Wind River Country at www.thenewflyfisher.com. For all of us here at The New Fly Fisher, thanks for watching. And remember, adventure is out there. All you need to do is go and find it, and what better way than to do it with a fly rod in your hand. Thanks for watching, and hopefully, we'll see you in the mountains of Dubois, Wyoming.
The New Fly Fisher is supported by Wind River Visitors Council, Orvis Fly Fishing, Trout Unlimited, Rio Products, Oscar Blues Brewery, Global Rescue, Adipose Boatworks.